The endocannabinoid system is found throughout the brain and nervous system within all mammalian species and is the most extensive biological system of receptors in the body. Humans are born with an endocannabinoid system that serves an important function in both the development of the brain and the formation and development of synapses, the electrical connections in the brain that allows neurotransmitters to send information. In this video, we'll dive into the subject of endocannabinoids and how they help us interpret reality. You're here with Mark Balwell at PerfectGardens.com. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. We got our $2.99 membership, and we have a VIP if you need a little more one-on-one. Link down in the description. Endocannabinoids and the receptors they bind to exist throughout the body in the nervous system, glands, immune cells, organs, brain, and connective tissues. The system permeates all 11 central physiological systems in the body, working to handle the many functions necessary for survival. The ECS works to balance our vital physiological functions, affecting everything from sleep, appetite, pain, inflammation, memory, mood, and reproduction. After reading tens of thousands of words published on the endocannabinoid system, as well as listening to like hundreds of hours of content, I have come to think God gave us this endocannabinoid system because He wanted us to interpret our reality a certain way. I was once told that the angels lacked the ability to have emotions, and this is the reason why human beings were created. We were created in this dimension to have emotions. With these emotions, angels can learn the lessons they lack the ability to have themselves. This is just my opinion now as I read, listen, and educate myself on subject that has captured my fascination and drive me to find the connection between it all. Before we get into how the endocannabinoid system works, I want to say thank you to our sponsors Whole Health Remedies. Because of their organically grown water extracted fungicide and pesticide-free CBD and CBG products, Perfect Gardens has now found a medicine that meets our standards. It isn't just clean, it is effective for sleep aid, pain management, digestive issues, and so much more. The medicine comes in tinctures, capsules, balms, and gummies. Remember to check out our pet tinctures for our four-legged friends. How the ECS works. The ECS helps to regulate homeostasis across all the physiological systems, ensuring they're all working in harmony with one another. External stress creates an increase in the stress hormone cortisol in your bloodstream, which leads to an increase in endocannabinoid production in response. The endocannabinoids increase with stress to balance cortisol production in the blood. Endocannabinoids are produced naturally inside of the body. Have you ever wondered why the entire endocannabinoid system is designed in one way or another to help us interpret our reality in a certain way? I'm not a conspiracy theorist, although I'm good at smelling bullshit. I find it really interesting that people with depression or other mental illnesses are given serotonin inhibitors. If you've ever taken one, you'll know that it can affect your sense of taste and smell as well as the speed of information. For me personally, it felt like I was walking through jello. Everything was just slow. I find it very interesting that a lot of the pharmaceutical industry uses drugs that affect our way of interpreting reality in one way or another. In addition, if you take these drugs, the side effects may cause you to not want to exercise or make love, which then affects your body's natural ability to create cannabinoids. Is our body craving cannabinoids right now? Are we deficient in one way or another? Do the pharmaceutical drugs that we're encouraged to take blocks our ability to interpret reality the way God intended? Compounds found outside the body like CBD and THC are called exogenous cannabinoids. CBD and THC are phytocannabinoids, meaning they originate from plants. Exogenous cannabinoids act similarly to the endocannabinoids produced by the body itself. The ECS works in the key lock model. Cannabinoids act as the keys within the endocannabinoid system. While receptors act like clocks, every time one key fits into one lock, the lock causes an effect to occur in the body. The ECS comprises three primary components: endocannabinoids, enzymes, and receptors. The two main types of endocannabinoids found in the body are anandamide and 2-AEG. 2-AEG is the most prevalent endocannabinoid responsible for managing appetite, pain response, and immune system functions. And anandamide is responsible for runner's high and the blissful states that come from exercise and meditation. Enzymes act within the ECS to recycle used endocannabinoids after the body's through with them. Receptors receive the messages transmitted by cannabinoids, the groups of active compounds that interact with ECS receptors. There are two main types of receptors, CB1 and CB2. CB1 receptors exist in the brain and spinal cord working to regulate appetite, memory, and to reduce pain. CB2 receptors are distributed within the immune system, working primarily to reduce inflammation throughout the body. In each part of the body, the endocannabinoid system performs different tasks, but the ECS always has one goal, homeostasis. This is why we highly recommend to use CBG because of its ability to bind with both the CB1 and CB2 receptors. The system works to keep the body stable through the inevitable changes and variations in the external, physical, and emotional environment. This unique system is the reason for the multiple therapy uses of medical cannabis. I personally would like to replace the word serotonin receptors with terpene receptors. We understand the word terpene for the smells that we get off the plant. They are the volatile compounds that attract us to the plant. The smells create a memory in our cellular DNA, something we could go back to and relive a moment our soul wants us to remember. How we interpret smell is because of our endocannabinoid system. It makes me wonder if these drugs are used to affect our ability to interpret our relationship with the higher power. The saying cannabis is the gateway drug may have another meaning. It could mean cannabis is the gateway to our interpretation of the lessons that angels and God created us to have.
So what was your total yield in flower?
In flower, it was 11.7 pounds.
11.7 pounds in this harvest. What about last year?
Yeah, it was
last harvest.
Last harvest was 2.2 kilos.